Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Want to invite you to enter our NCAA bracket. Go to MrExcel.com, NCAA.html, download the Excel spreadsheet, enter your picks, mail it back in. It's absolutely free. You have a great chance to win some Excel books. Now, we've been talking this week about the hassle of entering everyone's picks in the NCAA sheet. And we talked about how I had formulas to help choose the higher seed. That's what most people choose. And then yesterday we talked about formulas to check to make sure that I hadn't keyed any data in wrong. And really, for the first dozen or so years that we were doing the bracket, we basically keyed all that data in. But then we finally said, well, you know, it would be really easy if, rather than people faxing their entries into us, if we could give them an Excel workbook and have them fill out the entries themselves, with the guise, of course, of saying that it would be easier for you to choose Excel rather than having to get the USA Today and that whole thing. But then the great benefit to that is once people send the bracket back in, we then can electronically harvest their answers. So if you remember from last Friday, we have this bracket where basically we have the drop downs. People just have to go through and choose which team they would like. And then the next drop down is smart enough to offer the winners from round one. They fill in their name over here, fill in the tiebreaker and their email. They would email this back to me then. And what I do is basically once it arrives in the email, I open the workbook. And rather than having to copy and paste, we wrote a quick little macro and I tied it to Control G for gather. Gather all the entries from here. The macro basically goes through and it says, we're going to take this person and add them to the next available line in the worksheet. So I'll hit Control G, and just that quickly, it confirms that they chose all correct picks, and we'll take a look and we'll see that there is, sure enough, in row 15, the new person's entry. One thing that we've always done in our competitions, we have two players that are computer generated. The first player is called seed, and that person basically just chooses the higher seed all the way through. If you're scoring exactly the same as seed, we know that you really use no imagination whatsoever. The other player is a player called random. Now, most of the time, random does horribly because he knows nothing about basketball and just is choosing randomly. But there was a situation last year where the results were so crazy that random was actually in the top 5 or 6 for most of the tournament. One other feature about our pool is that it's so easy once the games start to actually figure out the results because Excel is doing all the formulas. We can then spend some time to take a look at people's picks and write some interesting commentary. And we always tend to make fun of anyone who's doing worse than random. Although, again, as I said, last year, that was more than 90% of the field. So today's Wednesday. You have less than a day. The games start tomorrow at noon. Go out to MrExcel.com, NCAA.html, download the bracket, fill it in, send it in. You have a chance to win some great books and a reason to pay attention to the NCAA Men's College Basketball Finals for the next 3 weeks. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow for another netcast from Mr. Excel.